attempt number two a week later. Been in touch with CyberLink support. They tell me I should be able to do it. So back at the Queen's Hotel, they have 2 cans of port pure. And also, Celt Experience have said, as of yesterday, they're stopping production. So I know they've got some Celt Experience in the fridge. And they'll crack at that as well. So the picture-in-picture works.
Yeah.
It's hard work. But this is why I'm here. Four pure. The American Pale Ale at 4.2%. Nope, the American Pale Ale at 5%. The Session IPA at 4.2%. I've got some Celt Experience out of the fridge waiting ready. Anyway, glasses are a bit big, but, you know, let's get into it. Number one, the Session IPA from Four Pure. 4.2% alcohol by volume and 42 IBUs. It's lovely. Rather large glass, but what the hell. Smells really nice. Complex start. It's really acidic finish. Quite tingly on the tongue, very tingly on the tongue. And I think that's going to be a bit of a grower. Fruity finish as well, it's fruity and acidic. B++. Two of two. Four pure American Pale, 5% alcohol by volume, 37 IBUs, international bittering units. Can you see the bubbles? Lots of them. Nice head. Nice fruity, hoppy aroma. Quite malty, actually. Acidic, long-lasting, bitter finish. B plus and a bit, 3.25 on the untapped scale. These are really good. Of the two, I think the Session IPA is the winner. However, if in doubt, get them both. Thank you, Queen's Hotel Newport. So there we are then. Two excellent cans in the fridge at your local Spoons. If they haven't got them, just ask them to order them. Well, I've got to be honest, the Queen's Hotel is out in front. Take them out of the fridge first, because they're slightly better, slightly warmer, because they are ales, not lagers. Anyway, hats off, Queen's Hotel Newport.